Hey there, friends, it is me, HLModTech, and I'm back with another cool CodeBlocks lesson. This one, it doesn't matter if it's your first, second, or fifth CodeBlocks lesson, it'll have all the pieces to help you be successful. So let's get cracking. Let's begin by scrolling down and clicking that CodeBlocks button. You'll see the cool starters. You can scroll down and find your code. I'm going to start with a brand new design, though. I always like to start with a name, and I'm going to call this Funhouse, and I'm going to put my initials after it. And because I like to practice, I'm going to call this Funhouse MDH3. For today's project, I want to make a house, and the first thing that I want you to do is under Modify, create a new object. Houses are made of walls, so let's click the rename variable and type wall in the little box that pops up and then press enter to lock it in. We're going to build our wall with some shapes, and we're going to start with a box. When that box lands, make sure you click the little arrow, and then we're going to put in the numbers 60 and 30, and then we're going to change the other one to 30 as well. 30 and 30. When you use CodeBlocks, you hit play, and then they draw on your screen just like that. If you look at it from the front, you can see that it draws right at 0, 0 on our screen. We want to raise our wall up, so then we're going to use a nifty command under Modify called Move. Since our height was 30, that means we've got to raise up half of 30, which is 15. When you type that number and then you click play, boom, our wall is all of a sudden up in the air. You may say, hey, that's just a big chunk, not a wall. Well, let me show you how we're going to fix that. Go back to your shapes and add another box, but take this box and make it a hole. Click its dimensions and let's subtract 4, making it 56 and making its length 26, and then we'll keep the height at 30. We need to raise it up just like we did the previous one, so go to Modify, choose Move, and put in your 15 as well. When you hit play, you can barely tell that anything happens because it hasn't been grouped yet. So we simply choose Create Group, and this time when you hit play, now we have instantly cut out 4 walls on our adorable little house. I just right-click rotated. You could also click the corners to look at it from whatever side you prefer. Real quickly before we move on, if you ever drop a piece off to the side, you can slide over and grab it with this little bar in the bottom. And then when you want to get rid of something, don't just touch the edge of the trash can. You've got to get your mouse completely on top for it to delete. Let's make a new object called a door. Once again, click on it, rename it, and type the word door. I will warn you, you cannot copy these create new objects, as it will not function. You always need to do create a new object. Later when you use variables, you'll always have to use create a new variable as well. You're going to have to trust me. I've learned that one the hard way. If we go to shapes, a door is made of a box once again. That door is going to be a hole instead of a color, and I want its measurements to be 10 wide, and I want it to be 6 deep, and I want it to be 15 high, because doors are usually taller than they are wide. Let's hit play, and you'll notice that it shows up right in the middle of our house. I'll look at it from the top, so now we just need to move it out here to place it. Once again, we're going to click on the modify, and we're going to bring out the move, and if we look at our grid here, you can see that there's 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 or so that we have to move on the y-axis. And since this is 0, that means it is negative 15. Let's see how that looks when we hit play. That lines up pretty good, but we need to fix that height, which is a raise of half of 15, which hopefully you know is 7.5. This time I'm going to increase the speed so it happens faster. You can see that now my house has a door pretty much in place, and I'm going to use a new technique to turn it into an actual house. We are going to once again choose that create new object. I like to keep these close together, but you got to make sure they always stay in order. Once again, we're going to rename it, and let's make it house or casa or whatever you want to call it. And then we're going to add a copy of our built objects. To do that, you move down to data, and here are our pieces. So we're going to add a copy of the wall, and then we're going to add a copy of the door. Back to modify, back to add a copy, back to data, and bam, drop the door in. That door needs to be a hole, and then we are going to go back to modify and use create a group. The initial pieces need to be out of our way, so we're going to delete both those objects with the delete object tool. We need two of those, and let's scroll down and let's delete the wall and let's delete the door. So now we use the copies, group them, and then delete the pieces. Let's see what it looks like. I'll slow down the speed so we can watch it happen. There are the walls built. Here comes my door. Now it's grouped. The parts are deleted. And shazam, we have got a house. Hopefully these techniques are making a little bit of sense to you. Right now, let's move our objects down. Let's create a new object in between. And maybe you're guessing, this new object should be called Win because it is going to be a window. Of course, the window is going to be made of a box, although you could be creative and make another window out of cylinders because those would look cool as well. We're going to make this a hole because we need to cut it out. And then I'm going to tell you that a good size is 10 by 10 by 10. Now, it's going to be thicker than we need, but that's all right because we're going to cut it out of all the different areas that we place it as well. I am not going to move my window. I'm going to just hit play. Notice the whole thing shows up once again. And this time, if we look at it from that top corner, there will be a window in the middle. I can't see over the wall, so I have to look at it from the top. We know that we have to move it 5 up because remember that it builds at 0, but we don't really care at the moment because we're going to do all that work inside the house. So right now let's move to the modify and let's add a copy of our win, going down to the data, finding that win, and then add it as a whole. And then we want to use another one of those moves, and this time we're going to move it to the left, forward, and up. So let's just try left 15. Let's try forward 15, which we know should work because we already used it with the door. And let's try up 10. Helps if you hit the numbers that you're saying. When we hit play, we can see what it looks like. Once again, I'm going to speed it up so that it goes faster. That doesn't feel high enough to me, so I'm going to raise it 15 high and hit play and see if I like that. I do like that. I can see that it's going to cut through. I'm going to change this to left 20 and hit play and check it out again. I like that a little better. I'm going to get all crazy though, and I'm going to try 17.5 to see if that really makes me happy. And I do like that because the amount on each side is similar. And you can adjust your numbers to make yours more awesome as well. Speaking of more awesome, we are going to finally work smarter instead of harder. Take the add copy and break it away. Do Control C and Control V, so now you have two of them. Take the second one, and instead of negative 17.5 to the left, make it go positive. When you hit play the next time, you have instantly got two windows dropped in place. I'm going to challenge you to add a bunch of windows, but before you get to work on that, let's add an awesome roof. If we look at our shapes, you'll notice there are several cool roofs that you can play with. I'm going to show you how to use this green roof. When you bring it in and hit play, see it drops at the wrong height. And it's obviously the wrong size. If we look at our measurements, the only adjustment we can make is the length adjustment. If we change that length to 30, it'll actually fit our building better, and we can prove it by looking at it from the top. See, it fills the area exactly. But then we've got to use another awesome tool called the scale tool to get it to fit in the other directions. Now, if you're looking at this closely, you may be able to figure out that it's going to take 1, 2, 3 in the X scale. So simply put a 3 there, and then I want my height to look cool, so I'm going to put it at 1.5. I'm going to look at it from the front corner, and I'm going to hit play to see just how nifty that looks. I'm going to finish it off with a move, and we need to move it up 30, but then we also need to add part of that height. So let's see what happens if we add 40. When we hit play, you can see that is too high. So let's try 37.5 and see if that works. That fraction is because we used that number 15 back in the day. When we hit play, poof, you have just instantly added a roof to your crazy cool house. Once again, I am going to challenge you to add amazing things like more windows, and maybe you can get crazy and add things on the top of your building like a chimney. You could put a couch, a TV, all kinds of amazing new objects in separate words underneath your house. I am going to wrap up my house by using the final create group to bring it to an end. When I hit play now, it'll actually cut those windows out. We can see it from the inside. If you are totally done with your windows, like I've challenged you to make more, but when you're finished, you can do that final delete object and bring in the little win word to clean it up and make it look a little bit more spectacular. Friends, I hope you had a ton of fun with this lesson. If you did, make sure you hit that like button. If you have a question, comment, or a suggestion, make sure you add it down below. If you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Mash that subscribe button, and last but not least, hit the notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new movie from me, HLModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.